Hey everybody, so it's Shug here. How you doing? Out flying some control line today on a windy Sunday here in Minnesota, and I wanted to show you my Strega. This is a 60 size airplane, meaning that it requires anything from a 50 to a 60 size engine. I have an Enya 61 engine on there. It was an RC engine that's converted to control line flying. So you take off the throttle, put a Venturi on there. I have, I think, a 12.6 prop on there. This is my fuel. I put in 4.5 to 5 ounces of fuel to get my 6-minute flight. This airplane weighs about 73 ounces, and it's an ARF, meaning it's almost ready to fly. It's a kit you buy, it's covered. You have to put the wings together, all the tail feathers. It requires assembly. They say 5 hours. Really, it's more like 15. By the time I did a few modifications, I made new flaps right there. I beefed the flaps up. I beefed up the firewall that holds the engine. I changed the push rods out. I used the belt crank that came with it. So if you've been in the hobby a while, you end up modifying some of these ARFs so you have a better system. So that's the deal. I'm out flying today, and I'll explain more as we go along. Now this is John, and he's got the Pathfinder here, which is a kit that he built, and he put in enough fuel so that he knows his flight, and now he's getting ready to crank it up, and he's waiting on me. Now this handle I'm using here, it's a Brodak handle, and it's kind of a made in the form of one called the old hot rock. It's a hard point handle, meaning my lines with my line clips come in and they're firmly and solidly directed and connected to the handle. A lot of handles, I'll show you later, have a cable coming from the handle. By the way, I'm using 0.018 19 strand stainless steel cables, and for the Strega, because it's got a 61 size engine, I'm using 65 feet on there. There are rules for your lines, like a 40 size engine, 35, normally use a 15. Now I've got an 18 on here because you get to a point where as your engine gets bigger, you need a stronger line. That's kind of the rules of control line, but you match your lines to the size of your engine. And also the way you compute the length you want to use is the wind. Today there's a lot of wind. Some guys might have a set of lines a foot or two shorter for really windy days. But because I fly stunt, I'm trying to get a lap time, meaning when I'm going around in a circle, I don't want that plane too fast or too slow. I'm looking for about a 5 second or 5.2 lap time, meaning from here to here. That gives me the speed I want to do my stunts properly. So I time my fuel so that I have about a six minute, five second run, which gets me through the pattern. And the pattern is 14 maneuvers with all the laps in between. And a lot of people ask the question about, well, aren't your lines all wrapped up and knotted up when you finish a flight? Yeah, if you're just out there goofing and you do nothing but inside loops, it'll be wrapped. But when you fly the pattern, what you're doing is you're doing 3 loops inside. So your lines wind up 3 times. You go around, you come out inverted, you fly inverted 6 laps, so your lines don't do anything. And then you fly 3 loops called an outside loop, and that unwinds your lines. So it's a series of stunts meant to wind your lines and then unwind your lines. Wind your lines and unwind your lines. So if you do a perfect pattern, your lines should not have, you know, any wraps in them when you're done. And that's kind of a basic explanation of that. So one thing you do between flights here is you grab your lines, and you can see I'm walking my lines out and I'm untangling them. So you walk your lines. Oftentimes I take a rag and you kind of wipe your lines off. So you're getting the twists out of the lines in between flights. A lot of guys walk their lines as they go out to fly. Okay, I had about a half a twist there. And then I just get my handle ready and lay it down. And another very important thing on control line flying with the handles, and its requirement now, is to use a tether. So when we go to fly, you put that tether on your wrist like this, then grab your handle. So you're tethered in there in case for some reason that handle gets out of your hand. You've got that tether, it'll automatically give your plane down and your plane will go into the ground. Better that than hurting somebody. So now we're gonna walk my plane out to the circle. I grab the handle. Because we do have these lines, Bob is grabbing my Strega. And we'll just carry that baby on out here into the wind. He sets her down right there. I come out, I lay my handle down, and then I take my tether and I make sure it's open. So when I come out here, I can put my hand in the tether, grab my handles, check my connectors. Everything's good to go. And I will take off. All right, now I'm taking my fuel syringe and I'm gonna suck in my 4.5 ounces of fuel, which will give me the perfect run. Now this is where I fuel this airplane. So that's an overflow, what I take there. I use this little piece of fuel tubing and a stopper to cover that. This right here is where air goes in and pushes air into the tank, which then pushes it into that Enya 61 dangling inverted right there. And that's called a tongue style muffler. So now I'll hook the fuel into the airflow, push it in. Bob sits waiting to be the Strega valet and hold me and launch me, which is a real important thing in control line. Now this is my electric starter I'll use. Get the cone on there properly. Instead of flipping that thing, I want to save my juggling fingers. I'll take this battery right here, hook that to the engine, but first I got to prime it. By that I mean I'm getting some fuel. It's probably a crazy ride for you while I do this. Got to get some fuel up into that engine. And I'll hook that battery up. And here we go. You got her, Bob?
I sure do.
All right. Get ready to fly in this wind. I always like to take a little bit of grass. Looks like the wind is heading straight toward the flyers. I put on my safety thong, my tether, check my lines, give Bob the go, and I'm off. Straighten this camera out. All right, we're gonna bring her down, come around and go for the reverse wing over. Now I notice when I use my handle, I put my thumb on top a lot. Some people say that's wrong, but it feels good for me. Do three inside loops. Now I go to inverted flight. I tend to hold my handle a little bit sideways for this.
Gonna do 4 laps.
Because when you're flying inverted, down is up, up is down. So when I go for these next loops, I want to give down input into my handle right now. And now I'm back out the level. So my lines should be unwrapped. Now I go for squares, and I know I keep my thumb on top. Not pretty. Now the treacherous outside square. I start from high, and I dive it straight toward the ground. Turn it up. To the ground, turn it up, and I'm out. That's always a thrilling maneuver. Now the triangles, which are way harder than they look to get right. All right, got those done. Now I'm feeling the wind in my back, and I'm gonna go for what's called the vertical eight. Two loops, and here we go. First loop, intersection, next loop, intersection, next loop, intersection, next loop, intersection, and out. Now we go for the square, same maneuver, except I'm trying to make squares. It's a hairy maneuver, so I'm gonna close my mouth. Going on with that one. All right, my next maneuver is going to be the vertical eight. So I do a loop, and then a loop over my head, then back, loop over my head, out, made it through in that wind. Now we got one called the hourglass, a very perplexing move. Way harder to do right, here we go. Not perfect. Now we're gonna go for the overhead eights. So I'm basically doing figure eights over my head, trying to get my intersections right over my head and keep it at 45 degrees, and then come out. And now the cloverleaf, which is always tough to get right. I'm gonna start up high, first loop. Over my head. Second loop comes across. Next one, over my head, back, and out, and across. And that got me through the pattern. Not pretty, but hopefully we can see what I was doing with my handle. I just feel way more confident with my thumb on top for most of it. You talk to different flyers, different guys do different things. Keith Sandberg, our club's best flyer, he flies with his thumb on top. So I think you just need to do what's good for you. But I do try to practice with my thumb off when I'm just working on level flights to fly this flight out. Because it's windy today, I'm running my engine a little bit leaner. It tends to lean out toward the end of the flight. So I'm going a bit faster right now, but sometimes you need that little bit of speed toward the end when you got to do those overhead maneuvers. Particularly if you look right now, you can see that wall. There's a highway behind it. There's the school, tennis court, woods. We got a wall right there. All right, here we go. She's starting to sputter, so I'll land. So that wind comes up over that wall, what it's doing today, and does some crazy things up overhead. I got a little bounce on that landing as I went into the wind, but all in all, not too shabby. I'll take it. Anytime the plane lands and it's still in one piece, that's a good flight. And what I'll do is just take a break, let the engine cool, and do another flight. All right, now that I've finished my flight, you can see that the planes with these glow engines, which is a fuel, it's nitromethane, castor oil, synthetic oil, it's all pre-mixed, and you tend to get some gunk and smudge, spligum, on your plane, particularly underneath. You can see some running here, but a lot of it runs out of the muffler, your castor or synthetic, and you can see it runs and gets your planes pretty greasy. So one of the things you got to do when you're done flying is wipe your plane down, and nobody likes that. Well, and then the other thing I do here is I've got to wrap my lines up. So I'll take my spool. That's my spool for my Strega lines right there, and I'll wrap up my lines and my handle, wipe down my plane, and everything goes back into my field kit. And right here, I've got a 12-volt motorcycle-type battery in there that runs my starter. I have a clotting sponge in here, which stops blood flow in case I do get a finger in a prop, because it does happen to people. I have my notes from my planes, keep a little log of what's going on with it, timers, little drawers of wrenches and whatnots and glow plugs and stuff. And one of the really important factors in trimming out one of these planes is your wingtip weight. And that keeps it tight on the lines. And there's a little box out here where you put these weights. I actually had to add a pretty good amount on here for my flying sight. And that weight helps keep the plane tight on the lines. And let's say I'm way down at that handle. Well, I'm pulling these lines up and down, flaps on the wings and the elevators work in unison. So that's up right there. You can see the elevator is up and the flaps go down to lift that front end. And when I want to go down, the flaps push the front end down. And neutral flight is right there. So everything's being controlled from there. Hopefully that's just going to answer some of the questions people have been asking me about it on YouTube. I'm just going to tell you this. It may look like we're just flying in circles, but this takes concentration the whole time, because you're never further than 75 feet from the ground, and you're diving at the ground a lot. And I know it's hard to, you know, tell people how thrilling it is, but man, every time I fly, I get a little buzz inside. So we'll talk more about these control line planes. I'll keep updating things. I want to do a thing on a more in-depth video on handles and lines, because there's not a lot of info on that. And I want to get some of the other club members and film them and get their ideas on their handles and their flying style. So one of the first things you do when you get ready to put it away for the day is you take your lines off of your airplane. That's called a line clip. I leave that one on the plane. I know that's my down, so I'll always know to hook this one up to that whenever I hook up my airplane. This one is my up, and this one stays on the line. So when I come here, I have these two like this, and these two are like this. So I always know where to hook each one. Then it's time to start wrapping the lines. Now my line is wrapped up, and I take the little clip and I clip that on my line. So next time I'm ready to fly, and this is brand new cable I put on here, so I'll write Strega on here, but I know that this is my Strega handle. I dedicate a handle for each plane, so this is my dedicated Strega handle. So when you fly an electric plane, which, you know, in today's world, a lot of guys fly only electric. I love flying my electrics close to the house when I sneak out, but I really do enjoy my glow engines. I love hearing that sound, but you do have to clean your plane up afterwards. With an electric, you might just have to wipe off some chopped up grass just from the propeller hitting the grass and it throws it up on the wing, but you don't have all the fuel and spludge and smudge and spligum on your plane. And I'll take it out in my nut hut and then really give it a final wipe. And that's what I do. We fly control line!